Is hair transplant suitable for my case? I'm 32, having hair loss problem, and it is quite serious at the top of my head. I've never been pregnant before and planning to get married and get pregnant next year. Am I a good candidate for hair transplant?
Thank you for your question. You submitted a photo that shows something called a widening of the part, and you're asking about whether or not you're a candidate for a hair transplant. And you shared that you've never been pregnant and you're planning to be married and pregnant in the upcoming year or so. And so the question then is, it doesn't make sense to get a hair transplant. Well, let's begin by answering the question by first diagnosing the problem. When a woman submits a photo and or comes to our office and complaining of hair loss, the most common cause is called female pattern hair loss. Now, there are two different scales that we refer to when we talk about hair loss. One is the Norwood-Hamilton scale for men, and the other is the Ludwig scale for women. When women have hair loss, there is a diffuse thinning of the entire scalp, and the frontal hairline tends to stay intact. Now, that's in contrast to male pattern hair loss, where there is recession of the temples and thinning of the crown. So, with female pattern hair loss, that widening of the part is a reflection of a diminishing of the overall density of hair. And sometimes, very often, we refer to it as a Christmas tree pattern, because when the part gets wider, it almost looks like a Christmas tree from the top view. So, something to learn about hair transplant versus other options. Well, for women, until recently, the only option for hair loss treatment was minoxidil. And then there were a lot of dermatologists who treated female pattern hair loss with corticosteroid injections. Now, that is based on a belief that female pattern hair loss has an inflammatory component. Many of our female patients come to our practice and say that they have itching, and that sign is not seen typically in men, and we'll notice that there is some type of tingling, and we believe that there is some inflammatory component to female pattern hair loss. But the problem is, at this time, we don't know what the cause is. Now, if you were to come to my practice in New York, and I can tell you that we've had an amazing opportunity to develop a non-surgical injection treatment that we have been very successful with for both male and female pattern hair loss. And it's based on a concept of wound healing such that the hair follicle is being protected. The background of this is based on bench research studies coming from the University of Pennsylvania, which determined that there are these cells called progenitor cells that are like adult stem cells that protect the hair follicle, almost like a shield effect. And so when they stop being functional, that's when the hair thins. And what that means is, as the hair growth cycle continues, new hair growth comes back thinner than previous growth. That's why they call it thinning hair. It goes from being a thick like an oak tree and getting smaller and smaller, becoming a sapling, and eventually just shutting off. So we have been able to use a material called extracellular matrix that I use as a surgeon in so many other areas for advanced wound healing, such as facelift incisions and other areas that I do cosmetic surgery as well as reconstructive surgery. We use that combined with platelet-rich plasma and we inject it into the scalp and do a certain specific protocol that I've developed. And we've been able to help a lot of women with hair loss. And when we talk about the percentage success at this time, 99% of our males have success measured by a clear improvement in hair quality and density, thickness, and 70% of our female patients notice a similar level of improvement. And it just usually takes a little bit longer. Most of our female patients notice improvement at about 9 months. Now, in terms of hair loss that women experience, there's a phenomenon called telogen effluvium, and that is sometimes referred to as stress hair loss. And in the hair growth stage, there is a percentage of hairs, about 8 to 10% of hairs, that for about 3 or 4 months are in a sleeping stage called telogen stage. Well, when there is stress, it's called telogen effluvium. And a lot of women will say, I had severe stress and my hair kept on falling out. And they'd come in a panic trying to figure out what's going on. Now, pregnancy can sometimes help thicken hair. And a lot of times, women will lose a lot of hair, whether it's during their pregnancy or immediately after. So I would actually discourage you from doing a hair transplant prior to your plans for your pregnancy. And in addition, because there are limited options for treating female pattern hair loss, from a surgical perspective, I try to discourage women from getting transplants because their progression can still go on. And since they don't have the option of using a drug like finasteride that men can do to prevent further loss, the choices are limited. And that's really why I'm very excited about our injection. In so many ways, the injection is both a vaccination, in other words, it prevents progression, and can turn around and re-thicken hair. So it's a very exciting time to be in this, what I feel is an emerging field of regenerative medicine. And in our practice specifically, hair regenerative medicine. And so if you were going to do something at all, I would consider that as an option, as a way to prevent the progression of your hair loss, because you cannot predict exactly what's going to happen related to your pregnancy. Now, if you're nervous about that, then I would say just hold off on everything altogether, because I don't think a transplant will do for you what you want. And if you were to lose more hair, then the benefit of a transplant may be too limited to appreciate, and the time and energy put in to doing it may not be worth the investment. So consider learning some more about this hair regenerative technology, and think of that in the context of the information I provided about hair transplant. So I wish you the best of luck. I hope that was helpful. Thank you for your question.